Hello, Javier Orozco, introducing within the nugget of architectural efficiency the second part on the constraint for facades, in other words, the solution we should be introducing, which are the last part for allowing us to do a proper material selection for facades. The solutions and assemblies that we should be integrating for facades. Let's go into them. First, there are different structural systems, either using different sticks, units which can be repeated in a modular way, and how to assemble both to a back facade or to the basic structure of the building. All these have a clear effect on the materials which should support either the module, the stick, and further materials for the facade, and therefore are the mechanical constraints we should be using and assessing when making the right material selection. Second, how are we going to connect the different elements of the facades between themselves and to the building? Remember that thermal bridges are an important problem, so we should close thermal conductivity from all different elements, both between the different modules or elements and to the structure of the building. This is essential for having a really efficient building. Second point is how to ensure either the expansion or contraction of materials with temperature. For that, we need flexible assemblies, and we should also, within these flexible assemblies, allow the movement of air in some cases and ensure that there are no additional stresses transmitted by the change of temperature of the facade, which can be very important, especially when we are dealing with metals. The guiding principles also that we have introduced to passive and active system are different elements that are new to the facade and which should be helped through the materials. In particular, we have, for example, new innovative solution. This is the easiest point because what we are doing is putting different layers or different elements supported with the same structure. Second, how to introduce other functions into the material. For example, photovoltaic elements or light, electrical light into the internal part of the building, or green infrastructure, which is supported by the facade. All these should include watering, for example, for the vertical greenery, the photovoltaic materials as different layers on top of glasses or other construction materials, or the electrical conducts and elements for producing light where it's most appropriate. The unusual or aesthetic values can change from the introduction of vertical greenery systems, introduction of a change of effect or light with temperature, with light and with the position of the sun towards the building. All these are very specific and should be studied with the response which is intended for the design of the building. The photovoltaics can be either in the glass elements or in the facade itself. Here we have an example of very simple integration, which is the substitution of part of the facade by photovoltaic elements. The most interesting application of this is introducing additional layers which do not change the aesthetical effect because they are very thin materials like the new perovskites with a few nanometers in thickness, and also adding additional layers at the back of the building for storing the energy, for example, in supercapacitors designed and manufactured as thin layers to the facade materials. Another possibility is to introduce new elements, for example, sun capture elements for the roof, which later can help the distribution of air, as is seen here, or the distribution of light through mirror ducts within the building. So, we capture the light outside, we capture the air outside, and distribute it through different conducts within the buildings. All these elements are connecting the outside to the inside and making good use of the natural resources. Other elements which should be considered inside the building: different sensors, ventilation, light pipes or shelves, as we introduced previously, which in itself are additional elements, are only affecting how to assemble them to the original facade. The innovation for heat distribution takes into account that air is coming in. We should renovate air, and we should use as less energy as possible for adapting the temperature. So we need filters, we need access to external air, to the most adequate point for throwing air out. That saves us a lot of energy, 7-8% of capital cost premium, and the operation savings can be up to 28%. So this is something very critical on how to assemble it through the facades in the building. Now we are in a good shape for doing the right material selection. As you see, in most cases, modern materials are hybrids, which are introducing the different functions. You have here a different example. The most relevant one, the most used in industry, the sandwich panels, or different multi-layers like in windows, or even composites for compensating one effect with another, for multifunctionality and synergetic behavior. The examples which I want to introduce for showing how this hybridization of materials is relevant are presented here. For example, composite materials for building envelopes. Here you have different films: protective films, color, aesthetics, pre-treatment for the right connection of all these different layers, the aluminium skin for having resistance and also a very light element, polyethylene, which is giving us the isolation with very low weight, and also some internal aluminium skills or finishings with different polymers, which allow an attractive interior for the facade. Other elements, for example, for advanced thermal insulation include different layers, which basically are different types of foams or phase-changing materials. These foams or these additional layers can have further effect by changes with temperature in phase, and that's how they can store energy, how they can respond to pressure producing electricity and having a sensor capability, and also how they can produce light or other functional benefits. That's the new age of nanomaterials and already introduced or material included sensors, which are very attractive for the near future. Thermal insulation can be as simple as putting natural materials or spacing the different layers and introducing air, which is one of the best isolations. Here you have a more developed example, which you should go in detail, how to assemble different modules of elements for producing units, which again can be assembled for producing the whole building. That's the trend with modularization and the functionalization of hybrid materials. Other properties which can be interested for layers: introduction of weaving of very resistant fibers, especially for ducts, as we see here. Five-axis weaving of this duct, as we see here, this is a very important mechanical resistance to external effects or to pressure in the inside. Assembling different composites which are easily shaped in final forms for the materials is very attractive and very cost effective, because we can use recycled materials. The resistance to impact in some situations where we have wind, for example, with small particles of sand, or we might have pieces of ice, raining ice, which is impacting the external walls. All this should be prevented by introducing the right layers. Another interesting new application is creating additional layers for self-healing. Some fibers, some polymers, whenever they are broken, they allow the expansion or internal monomers of the polymer to go out and repolymerize in order to heal, to close again the gap that was created through the impact. Another layer, which is connected also to polymers, is creating a vapor barrier and avoid condensation, which is a critical point in some buildings when there is a big thermal difference. The smart fibers can introduce deep structural monitoring, which is especially critical when we have earthquakes, and therefore we have to assess how you are influenced by previous impacts, previous earthquakes, and problems and damage to the structural of the building. Well, all these were simple examples that should allow you to create and to bind together all different materials to new hybrids for best performance of efficient facades. Thank you very much.